in this module 2 unit 5, you are able to learn a few things about peace studies and conflict resolution, which is the main thrust of GST202, a general studies course that you need to pass. Please take it serious. Module 2 unit 5 deals with peace and education. Peace education serves the purpose of teaching understanding and respect for all peoples, their cultures, civilizations, values, and ways of life, including domestic, ethnic, cultural, and culture of other nations. It is useful for increasing awareness of global interdependence between peoples and nations. No country is an island, so we need to understand ourselves to be able to deal with ourselves better. At the end of this unit, we should be able to discuss the connection between education and peace. Define peace education, identify the key issues in peace education, articulate the role of peace educators, and explain methods of achieving lasting peace. What does peace mean? Derived from the Latin word pax, which literally means a pact, a contract, an agreement. It means tranquility that pertains to an individual's sense of himself or herself has been at peace. Peace can pertain to an individual relative to his or her environment. An absence of hostility can be seen as peace. If you have safety, welfare, prosperity, security, fortune, friendliness, you may say that you are at peace. So these are different ways of looking at the word peace. And people have used different words to signify peace. In Hebrew, they have the word shalom. The Arabic word is salam, the Yoruba word alafia, and the Hebrew word is udo. These have been used by different cultures to mean peace. Education and peace. To teach understanding and respect for all peoples, their cultures, civilization, values, and ways of life, we need to do this through education. We need to improve the abilities of people to communicate with others, lead to an awareness not only of rights, but also of the duties they need to perform to make society better and live in peace. To remove the ignorance that is often associated with violence in human societies. Areas of pursuit of education for peace include training and practice of conflict resolution and mediation in school systems. Linkage of school activities to ongoing activities in communities. Like if there's a festival, you want people to partake of it and see what peace can be derived from such activities. Incorporation of discussion on social movements, peace and non-violence, democracy and good governance. Extension of the sense of community to all people's community participants, being part of the community. Approach to ethnic, racial and cultural differences. Systematic review and renovation of the teaching of history to lay more emphasis on non-violent social change as opposed to violent activities that are being carried out by different ethnic groups, by different militia groups, by insurgents, and also teaching of science as a tool which can be used for war or for peace. We want to use it for war, how to make its negative impact less on people. Peace education process of imparting specific skills, attitude, and knowledge in people. Helping them to solve problems by building consensus, creating cultural awareness and showing empathy, helping you to understand the nature and origins of violence and its effects on both victim and perpetrator, and creating consciousness and consent of the human being to do good, investigating the causes of conflict and violence embedded within perception, values, and attitude. All these are values of peace education, creating consciousness and conscience of the human, and empowering people with the skills, attitudes, and knowledge to build, maintain, and restore relationships at all levels of human interaction. The role of peace educators include encouraging a commitment to peace as a settled disposition and enhancing confidence, informing the student on the consequences of war and social injustice, informing the student on the values of peaceful and just social structures, and encouraging the student to imagine a peaceful future rather than this turbulent one that we are passing through. caring for the student and encouraging the student to care for others. These are the things that peace equators must do. The methods of achieving this includes peace building as a process that facilitates the establishment of political peace and tries to prevent the occurrence of violence by addressing the root causes of conflict and engaging in conflict transformation, which will be political economy. Methods of achieving also include central tasks of peace building to create positive peace, a stable equilibrium, social equilibrium in which the surfacing of new disputes does not escalate to violence and war. Structural dimension of peace building include focuses on social conditions that foster violent conflict, initiates social structural change, and provide fundamental service to its citizens, the states, and the needs of individuals, the legislature, the executive, and the judicial institution. Political structure changes focus on political development, stable state building, and the establishment of effective government institutions. Maintain rule of law and to implement rules and procedure constrain the powers of all the parties in order to build power equilibrium. The relational dimension of peace building includes reducing the effects of war related to hostility through the repair and transformation of damaged relationships. Reconciliation is one of the most effective and durable ways of transforming relationships and preventing destructive conflicts. Each side expresses sincere regret, remorse, and is prepared to apologize what has transpired before there can be forgiveness and reconciliation. Effective communication and negotiation feature imaging, whereby parties form a vision of what should be commonly shared in the community. Pursue joint projects that are unrelated to the conflicts or core issues so that there can be development. Promoting healing and ruling, and all the others we have listed online. Personal dimension of peace building centers or desired changes at the individual level. And we need to also ensure that we counsel people to be able to do what is right, to be able to understand social psychology of the environment where they live. Why is education important to the development of peace education? Because it will make people to understand better, to make people to relate better, to make people to foster a better living condition for all, and to respect the needs of the others as well as they respect their own. In this unit, we have examined the meaning of conflicts and its connection to education. We have also looked at various ways by human educate their members in peace, culture, and survival skills. Thank you for listening, and then we hope to meet next. And before we go, let me remind you that we have just come to the end of Module 2, Unit 5. And of course, that is the end of this module. We are moving to Module 3 next time when we meet. Thank you for being there.